Routers are considered layer 3 devices because they examine the packet portion of each data frame and they determine at the layer 3 network layer of the OSI model which network or LAN, local area network, that the destination device resides in, and it sends that data to that network as intended. Let me break that down a little bit here to make it simpler to understand. The purpose of a router is to route traffic from one network or local area network to another network. If you want to communicate with another computer on another network or LAN, you will have to have a router or a layer 3 capable switch to pass that traffic and data from your network to the other network and then back again if needed. As I talked about in the last section, switches use MAC addresses to determine where the traffic and data needs to be sent. This information is read from the frame portion of the data coming through it. Routers deal with IP addresses, so they actually don't too much care about the source and destination MAC addresses in the frame header. Instead, they look at the source and destination IP addresses in the packet portion of the data to determine what device sent it and which network that device is in and what device it's being sent to and what network that destination device is in. When data comes in on one of the ports on a router, the router reads the network packet portion of that data and looks at the network address information to determine its destination. Using the information it has in its own routing table, it sends that packet to the next network to allow the data to ultimately reach its final intended destination. In this process, the data may have to go through several routers. When it has to go through several routers, each of those steps is called a hop, by the way, in the networking industry. And it may have to go through several of those routers to get to that intended destination or that intended destination network. Now, a routing table or routing database on a router is stored in its RAM memory. The routing table on a particular router contains information about all of the directly connected networks, and it can be updated and maintained either dynamically, which is basically automatically by the router or routers themselves, using routing protocols, which I'll talk more about in a later lesson, or statically, where an admin or someone like yourself or somebody with access to the router settings actually goes in and enters the routes statically and the networks statically, and it's all done manually on each router. A routing table keeps track of certain important pieces of information, such as the network address assigned to all of the different interfaces on that router itself, the subnet masks that it has to deal with, the route sources, the destination network, the outgoing interface that that network is connected to. Again, as you get more into learning about IP addressing and IP version 4 and IP version 6 routing, and as you get more into learning about routers themselves, you'll understand more of this terminology and what it means and what it does. You can also go on to my Level 2 mini course on routers and learn a lot more there, which I'd highly recommend. Some of the key features of network routers are that they have the ability to filter on IP addresses and they do not forward broadcast or even multicast traffic. So, since they don't forward broadcast or multicast traffic, they can be used to separate broadcast and/or multicast domains, one of the major benefits to a router. They perform packet switching and packet filtering, very similar to the way a switch performs MAC switching and filtering, only they actually do this at the packet level using the IP address, source, and destination IP addresses. And routers have the ability to select a path or choose the best path of the next hop to get the data to the intended destination address and to get there as efficiently as possible. To sum up what a router does even more succinctly, if you have different networks, such as a network that has 192.168.10.0, and you have another network that's 192.168.25.0, and you want to send data between the two, then you need a router to perform that function, or at least a layer 3 switch that can perform routing functions using IP addresses. I did want to make one more side note here. Layer 3 switches can route traffic between networks very much like or very similar to a router, but they also perform switching functions by looking at the source and destination MAC addresses like any other layer 2 switch does. Now, typically, a layer 3 switch is not a replacement for a router, especially at an enterprise level, but a layer 3 switch can be used internally for different segments of a network within your organization. Typically in places where you might have slower or less traffic being routed from one internal network subnetwork to another internal subnetwork. So that's basically the rundown on what a router does how it's used, and why we need them.